What's up? Welcome to another fun and useful video. This is Frank. We're looking at a Toyota 3.0 liter V6 1MZ-FE engine, and we're going to set the timing belt, set the valve timing and timing belt on this engine. Okay, this is an old engine that I pulled out of a car and replaced it with a newer engine. This one has some rod knock, and decided rather than try to fix it, just swap it out, because you can get an engine for $800-900, and it's not really worth all the effort of trying to fix a rod knock situation not knowing exactly what's wrong with the engine. And so the replacement engine is a JDM, Japanese domestic market engine, and believed to have 40 or 50,000 miles. Anyway, that's a different story. What we're going to do today is demonstrate how you set the timing belt and the valve timing on this V6 dual overhead cam engine. And well, there's a lot of interesting stuff to say about this engine. We'll skip all over that, right? Because even though it's a dual overhead cam, you only see one cam up on top, and this is because of what's typical of a lot of older Toyota engines. The second cam is a slave cam. It's actually driven by the twin cam. Twin cam, right? So okay, what are the things to note here? On the crankshaft sprocket there is a dot, which is the timing mark. It's a little dot, and it has to line up with the little mark on the oil pump. And I've highlighted these to try and make them more visible. Okay? Then on the front bank, there's a mark on the cam sprocket, and it has to line up with a little indent in the cover. And same thing for the other cam. There's a mark that has to line up with the indent in the cover. Okay, and on the timing belt there are a number of marks that I will show you here. This mark, this series of dots, lines up with the second mark on the camshaft, I mean on the crankshaft, which is this tiny little dot. So these dots right here line up with that dot on the crankshaft. And these arrows up here actually point to the front of the engine. That's how it's intended to be. Then to make it easy to set this timing, there's a second mark, and these marks are very visible on all new timing belts, and this is an older timing belt, so I've highlighted the mark with marker. So this mark is for the front bank camshaft, and then there's another mark for the rear bank camshaft. Okay, so what we do to get this going, we start by get it all into position. Okay, let me look for these dots. The dots that go on the crankshaft, try to get them in approximately the right place at first, then they should fit right on to the shaft. Okay, I got them exactly where they need to go. So those dots that I showed you, let me make sure of that. Those dots that I showed you previously on the timing belt. Uh-oh, I'm off. Okay, so that's what happens, right? So okay, let's line them up now. Now they're lined up. Those dots that I showed you are now lined up with the dot on the crankshaft. Okay, and the crankshaft is in the correct position. Okay, so then I thread this belt over the water pump, take it over here, okay, and it it should line right up with the cam. Let's check that. So the mark is actually off by one tooth now. Okay, and to fix this situation, which can be a little bit tricky, right? That's where we want to use a wrench in order to rotate the camshaft back and forth, get it to line up. So I got a 17 millimeter wrench, and I want to advance this just a little bit. All right, I want to advance it just a little bit until it lines up. Okay, just want to, okay, now it lines up. Okay, so now I can move it back to line it back up with the timing cover. Okay, so it's nearly lined up. Okay, and we'll see now how much more we need to turn it so that the other cam also lines up. And it needs to turn just a tiny little bit. There we go. So now the second cam is also lined up with its mark, and we just apply a little bit of pressure and tension, and okay, by applying just a little bit of pressure and tension, now we can slide the belt all the way in place, okay, on both cams, and all the pulleys, all the marks, okay, everything is all perfectly lined up. All right, so there's just one more thing we need to do, which is to apply the tensioner. Here's the tensioner rod. I pressed it in with a press, and then I've inserted a little hex through the matching holes, and this allows me to put the tensioner in place where it belongs, pushing on the tensioner pulley. Okay, so we start one bolt first for the tensioner. Start one bolt, get it started, push the pulley a little bit. Oh, that's not gonna work. Let's redo that. Okay, so there we go. This should work. Okay, got it more or less in place. Okay, now just need to push on the tensioner to get the hole to line up. Okay, you just need to get the second hole to line up and line up the bolt. Okay, tensioner is actually putting up a little bit of resistance, which is what they like to do. The tensioner or pulley is not wanting to turn, so let's give it some slack. The way we're going to give it some slack is we're going to turn the crankshaft a little bit, okay? And this will put some slack on this side of the belt. Okay, there we go. And that did it. That completely put enough slack in so that we can put the tensioner in place. Okay. And I'm gonna just tighten it up a little bit. I'm gonna tighten up the tensioner. And the bozo who had this engine before me actually put the wrong bolt on the bottom position of the tensioner, right? Because he was a complete bozo, right? Because who does that? Who else does that but a complete bozo, All right, so now the tensioner is in position, everything is in position, and you can just use this vice grip to grab the little hex wrench and just pull it out. You're just going to keep pulling on it until it comes out. It needs a little more tension. Pull it out. Oh, here we go. Let's try it this way. And it's out, okay? So now we should finish tightening these bolts, of course. And the timing belt is on, and to test it, we're going to give it a few turns, but this engine being a little bit seized up, it's not going to turn very well. Anyway, all we need to do is verify that the marks are still lined up. We did move the crankshaft, but everything moved with it in perfect synchronicity. Everything stayed lined up, and now we have our timing belt on. And we're good to go. We would put, at this point, put the timing covers back on, close it up, and be good. So thanks for watching. Hope you find this useful, and have a great day.